Hello again, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the second half of the show. Just as a point of interest, if any of you have got completely soaked on the way here, at the moment the rain has stopped. To start our second half, Professor Spencer, was very rudely interrupted at the start of the show, so we decided to bring him back to complete his talk. May I present again, Professor Spencer.
I knew you'd want me back again. It does get boring, does it, when you're enjoying yourself too much? But I'm going straight into the middle ages.
Are you enjoying your drink?
I'd like to go back to. I'd like to go back to where it all started.
Hello!
Roman Empire started.
What lovely evening.
Hey, little girl!
Yeah.
told the props lady there was too much of this. I know.
What a dreadful place this is.
What's that smell?
Awful. It's not me.
I didn't say it was.
That's right. You go over there and have a look, and I'll have a look over here. Right, okay. If you see anything, give me a shout. Not me.
I know. I think it's a dragon. I think we found it.
I can't see it.
I know, but I can definitely feel a presence.
Like my knees knocking.
Oh, dear. Do you think we should ask the audience to help us find this dragon? Would you please help us find this dragon?
Mm. Yes. Yes.
Yeah, and you.
Please, we need a bit of help.
Please. We need to find the dragon.
No.
Please help us find the dragon.
Please.
No.
Thank you, girls. Thank you. I think we can rely on them. I don't think they've had enough to drink. I can't see anything now, can you? No. Sorry?
Where?
Over there. I think. Probably that swine of a Mexican I ate. Terrible trots all day. Oh, dear. Well, perhaps we can help you. Will, let's have a look in a spell book. Let's see if we can find a spell for Gaviscon. You know, the stuff that puts out fires. Oh, now, here we are. Bile and acid in his tongue. Come on, fireman with the Gaviscon.
That's better. Oh, that's better. Thank you very much.
Tell me, Dragon, you seem quite friendly and nice, not at all frightening.
Yeah, why are you all chained up? Well, you see, it's a long story. But as it's you and you've done me a favour, I'll cut it short. Your lord of the manor, he won me in a bet. He bet that England would beat Wales at rugby. So I've been here a few years, you see. Your lord, he thought it'd be a good idea to use fear of the dragon to extort money from the villagers. Just like his Sussex County Council. If any villagers come near, all I have to do is roar. It scares them silly and they pay up. But it's so lonely and the food is dreadful. In this chain, it's cutting my ankle, something awful.
Oh, you poor thing. Why are you chained up?
I'd be off like a shot if it wasn't. Off to find a retirement home for almost extinguished dragons.
Oh, I know one of those places. My auntie works in their charity shop. It's called Kit Wilson. And they're pleased to see you. They just down Stonehurst Lane. You can't miss it.
Silly girl, I can't go. The chain.
He's right.
What's
silly girl bit. The chain. I tell you what, let's have a look in that book. See if we can find a spell to free him.
Here we are. With a chain bound to a tree, cut the link and set it free.
Better, thank you. That's much better, thank you. Thank you very much. I think you deserve a song for that. Come on, children, let's give them a song. Come on. Now, I'm the sad old dragon who lives in wilderness wood. But I'm so hot I've burnt the lot, cause that's what dragons do. I wanna be a pensioner dragon and put my two claws up and be just like you other folk, sit back and have a sup. Oh, ooby-doo, I wanna be like you. I wanna walk like you, talk like you too. You see it's true, a dragon like me. Don't try to kid me, humans, but don't get in a stew. What I require is to retire so I can be like you. Give me a break, you humans, come on, show me what to do. You cut my chain, put out my flame, and make my dreams come true. Ooby-doo, I wanna be like you. Take my plastic to blow water for a bit of retail therapy. Thank you very much. I'll be off to my retirement home now. Ta-ra for now. Ta-ra.
But we've got a problem. Lord of the Manor sent me to kill the dragon. Rehabilitate him. What's he going to do? Shall I go back and look empty-handed? Look as though I haven't been in a fight.
Yes, yes. I've got it! I'm not blown off nothing. We've got the dragon's tail to show the Lord of the Manor, and I think with a little help from the witch's book, I'll find a spell to rough you up and make you look like you've been in a big fight. Now, here we are, to make a smart casual scruffy casualty. Oh. If he's not as neat can be, make him fit for casualty.
Ha ha ha!
I'm sore all over.
Oh, never mind. Listen, we've got to get back to the castle. And I think on the way we'll give this back to the witches. And you never know, they might have some ointment for your wounds.
I wouldn't bank on it.
Well, you don't know unless you ask. So come on, we've got to get back to the castle.
Oh, must we? Do we have to?
Yes, we do. Now, mind the steps.
I'm tired.
I know you're tired, darling. But come on, come
on. Come on. My legs are getting
there's a trick on the back. Come on.
Yeah.
I'm
simply
okay.
Watch out, watch out! Oh, 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 oh. I haven't set my line yet. Greetings for soup! The deep dark wood didn't suit me, so I stopped off for a quick jar at Dame Wilkshire's. Friendly soul, isn't she?
Yes.
Yes.
You don't know it then. Will the Sir Will and Nell thing happen? That's what I want to know, and I'm sure you do too. Right, I'm off to the nunnery. The nuns are having a bit of a knees up, I hear. Aye, aye. Here comes trouble. So I better get myself scarce.
Someone else I'd rather be. If I were not in pantomime, a milkmaid I'd be. You hear me all day long, I singing out this song. Pulling others, really ain't much fun. Pulling others, pull the other now something else I'd rather be. If I were not in pantomime, a woodcutter I would be. You hear me all day long, a singing out this song. Cut the trees down, crikey, what a whopper. Cut the trees down, look at my big chopper.
Every day.
Grow up, the pair of you. Right, that's it. I've had enough. I'm in charge here. You'll marry me, girl, and no arguments.
Mm. No, my lord.
She won't.
Oh, yes, she will.
No, my lord.
Now, beautiful man, I would be honoured if you'd become my wife.
Oh, that's torn it!
Right. That's it, mate. This time you cook your goose. God! God! Take him away. And charge him with taking as intended. He'll be brought to trial tomorrow, and if I'm not mistaken, the sentence will be death by tickling.
Oh, please, sir, have mercy on him. He's killed the dragon for you. Look, he's got the tail to prove it.
Exactly. Get up, madam. Get up.
Until our wedding, you will be incarcerated in the local nunnery. And God help you. And take that disgusting tail with you. Julius! Hang on, it's a big castle. Julius!
What?
Julius! Caesar!
It was a big one, wasn't it? I've never seen one like this in my whole life. Who would have thought it?
Yes, who would have thought it? But I've seen one like that a long, long time ago, the night the Lord of the Manor was born. I think we need to get to the bottom of this, my dear.
Literally?
Literally.
Something really, really fishy going on here. I think we need to investigate a bit further, my dear lady. There would be many, many lids open and curtains switched, but we will see the end of this. Mark my words. Woo!
Greetings, the sea! He's early in your life. The castle's been getting a bit lively, hasn't it? It's also been getting a bit lively at the nunnery, too. I told you those nuns were having a bit of a knees up, and they certainly were. It's been like Brighton on a Saturday night. Hang on a minute, here they come now.
Greetings, dear minstrel.
Sick of dedication.
some medication, cause I want to get alive.
Love a good execution.
Free the prisoner! Place him here, look at him!
Scum of Hadlow Down. The prisoner has been called here today to meet his fate. He has been accused and found guilty of mucking about with his lordship's intended.
I was never intended for that pig.
You tell him that. Or we must steal what we saw.
What do you mean?
Speak to
me, my love.
So, my dear, just a teensy-beensy bit tied up at the moment. It has been decreed today, the 28th day of November, in the fourth year of our gracious king, the protector of the realm, sovereign of the...
For goodness sake, get on with it. I want to get married.
Can't wait for the honeymoon.
Oh, no.
Yes, go on, Scribbler.
It's been decreed that this piece of rubbish will be tickled to death by the Spanish tickler.
Spanish tickler!
Quiet, Senor Tickler. Do your worst.
Are you ready, sir?
No.
You'll hardly feel a thing. Take your pick. Teeny, teeny one to start with. Hardly feel a thing. For goodness sake, Signora, I've hardly started. Where is your stamina? Okay, so let me think something else. How about the wiggly finger?
Talking about now. Get back to work, executioner.
Stop. Get off, you Spanish onion.
Wait, my man ceased. You cease. But Signora, that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to deceive him.
Right, that's it. I've had enough. I'm the law around here, the lord of the manor, the big cheese.
I thought there was a funny smell.
When I order an execution, I expect an execution.
My lords, are you sure you're the rightful heir to the manor of Hadley Down? Can you prove it?
How dare you? You've had a nunnery already, I thought you shot in a nunnery.
Ha! I shall take none of your nonsense. Balthus, my dear, did you not attend the birth of our esteemed lord?
Yes, I did, sister, and sadly I did too good a job.
And was there anything remarkable about the birth?
No, nothing really, apart from the birthmark, of course.
The birthmark?
Yes, the biggest, most unusual birthmark I've ever seen. Sort of like a row of candles.
How many candles?
Four.
No, not the And where was this mark?
It's coccyx. Oh, that's backside to you lot.
So, my lords, do you carry such a mark?
Well, I'm not saying, and I'm certainly not showing.
Oh, I'm sorry, my lord, we need to know. You know, hereditary lordship is a very democratic process here.
Who's owned the old china? Is it yes or no? We can always check.
Me old china? China? Well, it's no. I have so much, but I have no such mark, if you must know. We do have mirrors in the castle. Anyway, I want to know how this woman knows about such a thing.
Oh, I have undone myself for the sake of justice.
Oh dear, come sister, pull yourself together. If you can help Sir Will, tell us what you know.
Very well, I shall tell you all the truth. Many, many years ago, I was married to a man. He put me in child. And left me just before it was born. The birth took place on the very same day the lord and lady of this manor had their child. Dame Berthelot delivered both boys. Knowing my boy had an uncertain future ahead of himself without his father, and wanting more for him, I swapped the babies while the nurse working for Dame Berthelot wasn't looking. I knew my boy would be lord of the manor of Hadlow Down one day.
You mean you're my mother?
Yes, dear boy.
And the real lord? I gave him to a childless couple who sadly died some years ago. Then I joined the nunnery.
Do you know who the real lord is?
Sir Will, have you ever looked at your own coccyx?
No. Possibly see your own coccyx in the mirror. Before you ask, no one else has either.
Examine him.
With pleasure.
Pitch up a bit, sire.
Well, he's got the mark.
sire.
Oh, get up, you filthy rabble. Anybody can get a tattoo these days. He's fooled you, and so is she. Executioner, get back to work.
Si, senor. Now, where was it? Oh, yeah, the big one.
Come now. The archbishop awaits.
Not so fast. I think we need some help here. Oh, Bubble Bubble, we're in trouble. Come on, catch up with Bubble.
You call a cracker.
Oh, hello, Kevin.
Kevin!
Kevin, I'm so pleased to see you. About to be executed, and he's trying to carry me off.
I'm doing nothing of the sort.
Oh, yes, you are.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Oh, yes, you are.
Stop it, stop it. So bad for the nerves, you know. It's better that. Undo his shackles. And as for you, boyo, you left me in the deepest, darkest part of wilderness wood, chained up. No one to talk to. Lousy food. Just a piece of rancid rubber to look forward to on Sunday. You tricked these poor people of Hadlow down into thinking I was the monster. But now, boyo, the boot is on the other foot, isn't it now? Tickler, give him a bit of his medicine.
Yay!
Oh, no, not
this
Spanish
Tickler! You can't always believe everything you see.
Oh, never. And I worked for the man all my life. I always thought there was something not quite right about him, but it claimed for second mold cleansing, you know.
Thank you, dear Nell, for summoning the dragon and saving me. Now, I suppose I must assume my responsibilities as lord of this manor of Hadlow Down. Hear this. The increase in your tithes has been abolished.
Hooray!
Instead, a new and fairer community tax will be applied.
Oh.
On the occasion of my marriage to the lovely Nell, everyone in the village will receive a pig and a bottle of mead from the new inn.
That's if you can find the front door, sire. Last time we looked, little Bollard and all the Bollard brothers were blocking it.
Can we invite everyone to the wedding?
Of course we can.
Including the dragon?
He can be in charge of the barbecue. Scrooge?
Of course, sir.
You'll see to the arrangements. Page Turner, you'll notify the Archbishop.
Yes, my lord.
Come, my dear, and Dame Berthelot. You must go and tell my new mother what's been going on.
For the last time, greetings for Sue. Oh, I do like a happy ending. So here's your time to send some happy vibes to the lovely couple. Sister Isabella, Page Turner, witches, come out here and help me control this lot.
Let's go.
friends, our tale is ended. The truth is out, and all is mended. All has turned out very well for our hero Will and Cracker Nell. Mirth and laughter, lesbian tongues. We wish you all the season's greeting and happiness till our next meeting. And so, dear friends, all wrongs and rights, we bid you all a fond good night.
Finish on, you're gonna finish on. We're gonna Sunshine,
yeah,
moonlight, good times,
good times.